According to the EPA, as much as 50% of the water we use outdoors is wasted through inefficient irrigation methods and systems. One way to easily reduce this water waste is by adding a soil moisture sensor to an irrigation controller. The WaterTec S100 soil moisture sensor from Baseline can help eliminate unneeded irrigation cycles. It does this by interrupting the signal between the irrigation controller and the valve if the soil is already hydrated as a result of a previous irrigation cycle or from recent rainfall. It's also compatible with just about any irrigation controller. The first thing you need to decide when adding a soil moisture sensor is where to place it in your landscape. Choose a zone in your system that requires the most frequent irrigation. Within that zone, place a sensor in an area that receives average to slightly less than average water from the irrigation system. A spot midway between two sprinkler heads is usually ideal. The sensor will eventually be connected to the valve that feeds the selected zone, and the control unit will be installed next to the irrigation controller. Be aware that the distance from the sensor to the control unit cannot exceed 500 feet. This includes the length of the wires running from the valve to the irrigation controller. Once you've determined where you will bury the sensor, it's a good idea to make a note of the location in case you need to find it in the future. At this point, you can dig a hole for the sensor, as well as a small channel for the communication wires that leads back to the valve. The hole for the sensor should be deep enough to bury it on its long edge with the top 2 to 3 inches below the soil surface. The channel for the communication wires should also be deep enough to avoid any damage from future aeration. Before you bury the sensor, run its wires back to the valve that feeds the zone where the sensor is located. Determine which of the valve wires is hot and which is common. Then splice in the appropriate sensor wire to each connection. The white wire should be attached to the common connection, and the red should be connected to the hot wire that controls the valve. Secure both sides with standard wire nuts until you've completed testing the unit. Later, they'll be replaced with waterproof wire connectors. Now, mount the S100 control unit next to your controller. Be aware that the unit is water resistant, but not waterproof. If you're mounting it outdoors, make sure it's protected from direct contact with water. To begin wiring the S100 control unit to your irrigation controller, disconnect the wire currently connected to the common terminal on the controller. Connect that wire to the white wire coming from the S100 harness, then connect the black wire from the S100 to the common terminal on the irrigation controller. Next, locate the terminal for the valve wire for the sensor zone, disconnect the wire, and then connect it to the red wire from the S100. To complete the circuit, connect the green wire from the S100 to the same valve terminal. In order to provide power to the control unit, connect the orange wire from the S100 to an available 24-volt terminal on the irrigation controller. Touch the end of the orange wire to each of the available terminals while observing the S100 control unit for an indication light. Attach the orange wire to the terminal that triggers the light. Finally, if you have irrigation zones that you do not want to be affected by the sensor, you do have the option to bypass two of them. Connect either the blue or brown wire from the S100 harness to any valve terminal that you would like to bypass. Be sure not to remove the existing valve wire when you do this. Once everything is connected, you can run a communication test between the controller and the sensor. To do this, press and hold the plus, minus, and read set buttons simultaneously for 3 seconds, then release. The communication test will take about 2 minutes as it triggers the sensor to take 100 readings. When the test is complete, the display will show the number of errors received. A reading of 000 means there were no errors. If you do receive an error, verify that all of your connections are correct and test again. Refer to the manufacturer's manual for details if you continue to see errors. After completing a successful test, finish the installation by burying the sensor. Make sure that it's not tilted at an angle. This can lead to incorrect readings due to water pooling on the surface of the sensor. Also, make sure you have good soil sensor contact by packing the soil down tightly around it. Air pockets, rocks, or gravel resting against the sensor can negatively affect readings. Now, bury the communication wires and reconnect them to the valve using waterproof connectors. Finally, saturate the soil around the sensor with a garden hose or a bucket of water. This will allow the soil to settle and will also provide the hydration required for the calibration process, which is covered in a separate video. If you would like to learn more about the variety of sensors that can help you better manage the irrigation of your landscape, contact your nearest Ewing branch or visit us online at ewingirrigation.com.